Old habits never open new doors. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we learn how to develop habits that change your life for the better. Enjoy.
Most of us want to improve our lives, but for that to happen, we need to adapt certain positive habits. Fundamentally speaking, habits play a key role in our day-to-day lives. But not all habits are created equal. Some can have a much bigger impact than others. This is why it's important that we learn to identify these habits and develop them. Charles Duhigg, author of the book The Power of Habit, calls them keystone habits. So, what is a keystone habit? To put it simply, a keystone habit is a single habit that allows for other habits in your life to be sustained. It's not much different from a normal habit, it's just that it has the most potential to transform your entire life. That's because keystone habits spark a chain reaction that can have a domino effect and other habits take hold. And often we're not even consciously trying to form all those other habits, they're just a byproduct of the keystone habit. Let me give you an example. This is Mike. One day he decided that he wanted to make a change in his life. He realized that all he did was work and spend time at home watching TV and playing video games. So Mike decided to pick up a healthy new hobby, which was exercise. He bought a gym membership and made a commitment to train there at least 3 times per week. Now, unbeknown to Mike, his new exercise habit would slowly create other new positive habits. Mike was a regular smoker, but once he started exercising, he found himself smoking less and less. Cigarettes were Mike's way of dealing with the stress at his job, but exercise offered a much better alternative for stress management. Because Mike was worn out after his workouts, his sleep improved. He fell asleep faster and had less awakenings during the night. As a result, his energy throughout the day skyrocketed. He became more productive at work and was even able to land a promotion. Mike even picked up cooking as a new hobby so he could eat more protein-rich meals to make more progress at the gym. And because he was now cooking most of his meals, he started saving money since he wasn't eating out at expensive restaurants all the time. Mike became a completely new person in the span of 6 months. But he didn't try to make all these changes at first. The only change he committed to was exercising 3 times per week. It's just that his commitment had a domino effect and he formed other habits as a result. This is the power of keystone habits. Just one change can lead to an avalanche of other changes. And stories like these are not uncommon. There are many people who attribute a single habit change to their life transformation. However, if you take away their keystone habit, all other habits tend to become less stable and sometimes they completely crumble and fall apart. This is why you need to protect the positive keystone habit at any cost. Of course, while there are beneficial keystone habits, we have to know that there are also damaging keystone habits. A positive habit can transform you into a better person, but a negative habit can leave you escalating down towards the bottom. So it's important that you identify any current habits that could be holding you back and make sure you break them. If you manage to break a damaging keystone habit, you'll find that the other bad habits often crumble as well. Now, let me give you a few keystone habits I believe have the most potential to lead you to other good habits. The first keystone you should try to acquire is any habit from the health trinity. What's a health trinity, you might ask? Exercise, diet, and sleep. All these habits are likely to lead you to other good habits, but most importantly, they also tend to build on each other. For example, eating a better diet leads to better sleep. But getting better sleep also leads to fewer urges and more willpower to stick to a diet. You get the idea. You can start wherever you want with the health trinity, and slowly you'll end up building the other two health habits. We've seen how Mike improved his life by starting an exercise regime. But I believe improving your sleep first can have an even bigger impact. You might have noticed I make a lot of videos related to sleep on this channel. The reason is because sleep is the most important keystone habit for me personally. It simply improves everything else. I have noticed that whenever I get good sleep, everything becomes easier. I'm more motivated to do things, I have tons of energy, better focus, and more self-control. In turn, this makes doing all my other habits a piece of cake. Practicing the piano? Super easy. Going to the gym? Barely an inconvenience. However, if I don't get my optimal sleep, I can see a noticeable difference. I don't have motivation, my energy is lower, I don't have much willpower, plus everything becomes a chore. That's why I try to get the best sleep possible every single night, because this one habit has the biggest impact on my day. And if you're not optimizing your sleep yet, I highly suggest you try for at least 1 month. I guarantee you'll see a ton of positive changes in your life. Another good keystone habit is planning and tracking your activities. Planning is self-explanatory. Sitting down for just a few minutes and developing a detailed plan for the day or even the whole week can help you prioritize things better. However, if you don't make any plans, you're more likely to just go through the day with no real direction. So if you want to make any of your habits stick, it's wise to plan them out.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.